Alright, in previous video we set up Atom. Atom is a way to edit files, and we have installed some syntax, so that's why everything is here purple. So check out previous video if it's not looking like it is now. This is Minimap, just easy to grab and go to wherever position in this long list, which is not that long, 400 lines, to get everything working. So there's a lot of information in here. You see already that pigments is working. This code is blue. Well, this is white, well, whitish, gray, and this is pink, purple. Anyway, lots of coloring and lots of syntax help you, and this is our D menu, super shift D. That color is this color. When I change the color, change this line and you have another color. Simple as that. So this is Xmonad HS. This is the most important file, Haskell HS. Most important file there is. This is also the core, right? Anything goes wrong here, it won't get compiled. It's as simple as forgetting this thing. It's not working. You see in the coloring that it will not work. Let's move it up here. Everything becomes green. It will fault. It will not build, it will not compile. The rest of the files are uninteresting, as you can see. It's quite readable. And this one as well, very interesting indeed. So it's an application, and that's the proof. If there are errors, you'll see them here. Again, something obviously very interesting. And our wallpaper. And then we end up with our script. So we have a scripts folder, and in the scripts folder, this is the major application where everything starts. Why does it start with this? Let's go back up here. Here is better. Here it says, my startup hook. Go to your home, go to Xmonad, in the folder scripts, auto start sh. So everything starts up with this. So basically, this is where life starts, your installation begins. If anything goes wrong here, then well, you have to figure out why is it not working, and it's going to be in the auto start. Content toggle sh is another one. If you want to toggle between transparency, content, shadow, and not, then it's here, and there's a little shortcut for it to toggle between both options. So basically, you hear already the word content, meaning that Xmonad is also relying on content like boxes and i3s and so many other desktops. We have here a set screen resolution sh, just to show you that it's possible as well. But this is a way to figure out if a resolution is not available. I was at some point in time in VirtualBox, I think it was around the changes of VirtualBox 5 and 6. Anyway, if you do not get the resolution you require, and this is my maximum resolution for my screen, it was not available, so I created it myself. So this is an option. If VirtualBox, VMware, any virtual machine says, I can't do this resolution that you need, then, and here's all the information, then these are the three lines and everything worked fine afterwards. And here's a little conky. So all the elements that we had here, all these shortcuts, that's this little conky. And that's basically all you need to know. So to start again, or to synthesize, auto start is the one you need to look at, and Xmonad HS. Those two. And let's now go into detail in the next video.